Welcome to the lecture, Introduction to R Programming. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about statistical functions. In this, first we will see introduction, frequencies, and partition values. We can recall in the earlier lectures, we discussed about various functions, various operations, and working with some inbuilt functions, then conditional loops are discussed. From this lecture onwards, we will move to some advanced concepts using statistics. Here, we won't concentrate high on statistics. We will consider the basics of statistics. Using statistics, then using some graphical tools, we can represent the data in the form of graphical representation, data visualization. So in this lecture, first we will see the introduction about statistical functions. Then we will see descriptive statistics. What are various graphical tools? Then two important terms we are going to use, absolute and relative frequencies, then various types of partition values, finally conclusion. Then coming to introduction, consider the statistics which can be used with one variable and statistics that can be used with two variables. So here two cases, statistics that can be using one variable and using two variables. There is another aspect, graphics. How to draw different types of graphics in R software. Usually we have a set of data that is collected from anywhere, from some external sources, or somebody has collected it himself, or say herself, or there can be various sources from which the data can be obtained. These are all the various sources of collecting data. Then the role of statistics is to provide different types of information which are hidden inside the data, and statistics is a language to explain the futures or to extract the futures which are hidden inside the data. So these are all the various aspects of statistics. Then coming to descriptive statistics, here some of the primary tools which gives the first hand information. The first one is central tendency of data. Second one, variation in data. Third one, structure and shape of data tendency. Then last one, relationship study. These are all the primary tools which gives the first, means primary information. Graphical as well as analytical tools are used to represent these primary tools. These are all related to descriptive statistics. Then coming to graphical tools. So we have various graphical tools are there. Here we will present various types of plots. So 2D and 3D plots, scatter diagram, pie diagram, histogram, bar plot, stem and leaf plot, box plot, etc. So in this lecture and upcoming lectures, we will discuss about all these graphical tools demonstration. Then coming to absolute and relative frequencies. These two are very, very important for handling statistical analysis as well as graphical tools. Suppose let us start with an example. So there are 10 persons coded into two categories. One is male category, another one female category. So male category, we will use the letter M. For female category, we will use the letter F. Now, the two categories values are the first one M, second one F, third one M, then F, then M, 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 F, M, M. These are all the 10 persons category, male, female. So by using A1 and A2 to refer to male and female categories. Let us take A1 is male category, A2 is female category by introducing these two variables. So there are, now you can count how many male and how many female. So here total, you can see male 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 male and remaining 3 female persons are there. You can denote as N1 equal to 7 and N2 equal to 3. Now the number of observations in a particular category is called the absolute frequency. So here two categories. Category 1 is male. How many observations? We have 7 male observations. That is one absolute frequency of that category. Then second category, female category, N2. We have 3 female persons. Now total number of observations of this category is 3. So this is absolute frequency. Then coming to relative frequencies. So here let us take A1, A2, previously we assumed. Now the relative frequencies for category 1 and category 2 are denoted by using the following formulas. So for category 1, let us the relative frequency F1 equal to N1 divided by N1 plus N2. Here we assumed N1 is the category 1 total number of males and N2 category 2 total number of females. Similarly, for category 2 relative frequency, so category 2 means female related, so first numerator you can take N2 divided by N1 plus N2. Now you can substitute the values. Previously we assumed, you can recall, N1 equal to 7, N2 equal to 3. So you can substitute in the following formulas. You will get relative frequencies of both category 1 and category 2 named as F1 and F2. Therefore, F1 equal to N1 by N1 plus N2 equal to N1 equal to 7. Then total N1 plus N2, 7 plus 3, 10. 7 by 10, 0.7, then 70%. Then category 2, that is female category, the relative frequency is N2 by N1 plus N2. So here N2 equal to 3, N1 plus N2, 7 plus 3, 10. That is equal to 3 by 10, equal to 0.3, equal to 30%. So like that, we will calculate the relative frequencies based on the given categories. Whereas absolute frequency means the number of observations category wise. So this gives us information about the proportions of male and female persons, this relative frequencies. Now, using our software, so how to calculate this absolute and relative frequencies? So for this, we will use the function table. So the syntax is table within parentheses, you can provide the variable name, so which creates the absolute frequency of the variable of the data file. So whenever you can use a table of variable name, which creates the absolute frequency of the variable of the data file, that means number of observations in that variable. Here enter data as X, let us assume, then table of X. So absolute frequency of the variable X. With relative frequency as for the formula, so here we'll use table of X divided by length of X. First you can calculate length of X, then table of X will obtain using the above command, then table of X divided by length of X, which gives the relative frequency. That is the difference between absolute frequency and relative frequency. In our software, using table of X we'll find absolute frequency, then using table of X divided by length of X we'll find relative frequencies. Now let us see the example. Same example we will consider. Code the 10 persons by using, say, 1 for male and 2 for female. So the data is represented in the table. So by headings as male, female, then the values. are represented here. So now, using this data, here we coded one as male, two as female. So wherever male is there, you can put as one. Wherever female is there, you can put code as two. So male is one, female is two. Male is one, female is two, like that. So total 10 observations are there. Now using this data, we will find the absolute frequency and the relative frequency using the previous syntaxes. So then first open our software. You can create a vector with the 10 observations, make it as gender equal to C of. So whatever the observations we have taken, that you can enter here, 1, 2, 1, and so on, all the 10 values. Then whenever you can call gender, so it displays the 10 observations. So after executing, this is the output screen. We'll also demonstrate. So then coming to first generate the table of gender to find the absolute frequencies. So table of gender, here X is the gender we have considered. Whenever you can execute this one, table of gender, it displays the variable name as the heading gender. Then it provides column headings as the codes. Here we have taken the code 1 as male, 2 as female. Then row values, as for the headings, it defines how many code 1 values are there, how many code 2 values are there. That means code 1 means male. How many male are there? 7 male. Code 2 means female. How many female are there? 3. So this is the tabular format by using table of gender. So which gives the absolute frequency, which shows the total number of observations based on the category. Now here category 1 is male category. How many observations? 7. Category 2 is female category. How many observations? 3 observations. So this is absolute frequency. So whenever you can execute this one, this is the output we will obtain. We will also demonstrate all this one by one. Then coming to length. So why length is used? For finding relative frequencies, we'll use length. So by using the function length, then you can provide the variable name. So here we have taken gender is our vector. So length of gender, which gives the total number of observations in the variable gender, total 10 are there. Now using the formula, table of gender divided by length of gender. So then it gives the relative frequencies. So by calculating table of gender, it takes the previous values that can be divided by length of gender 10. So previously we have in the table under category 1, we have 7. Now 7 by the length is 10. 7 by 10, 0.7. Then under category 2, the total observation is 3. 3 by, now the length is 10. 3 by 10, 0.3. So this is the output we obtain. Now this is called as relative frequencies. So absolute frequency, as it is, the observations category wise. Whereas relative frequency, which gives the proportionate of the ratio of percentage of male and female. So now we'll also demonstrate this one. So by finding absolute frequency and relative frequencies. Now we can open our software. So now first we can create one vector, name it as gender equal to C of. See the observations you can type here. So observations 1, 2, 1. 1, 2, 1. Then 2, triple 1. 2, 1, 1, 1. So 2, triple 1. Then 2, double 1. So total 10 observations. Now we can call gender. See the 10 values. So then using table of the variable gender, which gives absolute frequency. Now you can see this is the absolute frequency of the variable gender using table. So then first you can find the length of gender, which gives the total number of count presented in the gender. So total values 10 values. So then using the formula table of gender divided by length of, so length of gender, which gives the relative frequency. Here you can see the formula, table of gender divided by length of gender. Now you can see this is the relative frequency, this is absolute frequency. You can observe the difference, total number of observations, then relative frequency, the proportionate. So this is one example. Now we can take our own example, own data. So using our own data also, we can find the absolute and relative frequencies. So in our earlier lecture, we considered the COVID data age group details as a CSV file. So now here I renamed it as agegroupdetails1.csv. Contains the simulated data on COVID age group details. There are three variables in this data: age group, total cases, and percentage. So the data set captures age group and total cases, then percentage will be calculated. Using this data set, we will find the absolute and relative frequencies. So before proceeding with our own data, first we have to set the path. So where that your own CSV file is located, you can set that path. So then you can move the data into one vector name. Then you can call the data using read.csv, the file name .csv. So first we'll see what is our current path we are working here. So whenever you can type getwd, get working directory. So C users admin documents. But that file is located in C. So here I have copied the commands. So I am setting the path here. That is in, I stored in week 7. This is my current path now, where the file is located. Again, you can see getwd. Now your path is changed previous to this one. So now we'll use the command read.csv to read the file. Now I'm storing that age group details into COVID. Now you can call COVID. The data is moved to COVID now. See, this is the data available in the age group details one.csv. Serial number, age group, total cases, percentage. Now by taking any one variable, we will calculate now the absolute and relative frequencies. So here, this is the COVID data, what we obtained from that Excel. This is the path we set and we called. So now here we are defining one vector taken from the variable total cases. So total cases equal to, you can enter all the total cases values which are available in the CSV file. So with that, you can find the relative and absolute frequencies. So now I am creating one vector with the name as total cases. I have taken the name as same as the variable name. This is the total cases. So all these cases you can store into vector C of first what we have 22, 127, 172, 114, 77, 89, 27, 10, 22. So all the values related to the column total cases. So I have moved into one vector total cases. So now with the total cases, you can work out, then you can find out the relative and absolute frequencies of this variable. Now we can see total cases. So here I got. Now we can find absolute frequency. So table of total cases. You can enter as it is, whatever the name we have given. Total cases. Now you can see this is the table of total cases, means absolute frequencies. So here how this was generated, you can see the total cases vector values are not in order. it may be jumbling order. Now it sorts in the order, then each value can be make it as column heading. The least value is 10, that is column 1. Next least value is 22, column 2. Next value is 27, that is column 3. Next after 27, what we have 77. Next we have 89. Next we have 112. Next we have 146. Next we have 172. It makes that number of unique column names. Now column wise, it provides the observations, total how many observations. First 10, how many times 10 is repeated in this total cases vector? 10 is repeated only once. So the absolute frequency is 1, total observations of category 10. Then total observations of category 2, that means 22. How many times 22 is repeated? Here you can see first value, last value. 2 times it is repeated, so it is 2. Then 27, it is repeated twice, so its absolute frequency is 2. Then 77 is repeated one, only 1. 89 also only 1. 112 also only 1. 146 only 1. 171 also only 1. So only 1 time. So this is absolute frequency. Same we can find out relative frequency. For that you need to find length. So length of total cases. So here we have 10 observations. You wrongly entered cases. So length spelling is wrongly entered. L-E-N-G-T-H. Here you can see length of total cases. So in the vector total cases, how many values are there? Total 10 values are there. So now using the formula table of total cases divided by length of total cases. So you will get a relative frequency. Now you can see. So this is the relative frequency of the variable total cases. Whereas this one, absolute frequency of the variable total cases. So this is our own data. So own data. So we have calculated absolute and relative frequencies. So like that, you can take your own example in your own data set. So you have to demonstrate by calculating the statistical measures, absolute frequency and relative frequencies. So that's all about absolute and relative frequencies. Now we will move to our next concept, partition values. So here, partition values means we can divide the database into different subparts. So here, such values divides the total frequency given data into required number of partitions. Here, by default, the partitions are divided into the following categories. The first one is quartile, divides the data into 4 equal parts. The second one, decile, divides the data into 10 equal parts. Then percentile divides the data into 100 equal parts. So the frequency distribution by default for any given data, these are all the default partitions. 4 equal parts, quartile, 10 equal parts, decile, percentile, 100 equal parts. How this can be demonstrated in our software? Then how to distribute the data with our own distribution, that is also possible here. So here we'll use the function quantile. So this quantile function computes quantiles corresponding to given probabilities. The smallest observation corresponds to a probability of 0 and the largest to a probability of 1. So you take the probability range 0 and 1, smallest value is 0, highest value is 1. In between 0, 1 range only it distributes. So the syntax for this function, quantile x comma, so here other parameters, second one you can see, quantile x comma probability is equal to sequence of, here the distribution values you can give here in between 0, 1, so 0, 1, then 0.25, like that you can give 0.5, 0.75, like that you can give the distribution, whatever the probabilities you can provide using sequence, the data is distributed according to this proportionate. So in this syntax, x represents a numeric vector, only numeric vector you have taken, whose sample quantiles were wanted. Then probabilities, PROBS, numeric vector of probabilities with the values in 0, 1. So using this quantile function, so you can divide the data based on the probabilities given here. If you won't give probability, default divides with default distribution. Now let us take one example. Marks of 10 students. So here I have taken the marks data and stored in the vector named as marks equal to C of, here you can see these are all the marks I have taken, 15 students, 68, 82 and so on, different marks values. Then you can call the vector marks, it displays the marks value. Then whenever you can apply the quantile function for distribution of the data with different ranges. Now it takes a quantile of marks default, it takes 0, 25, 50, 75, 100 range. So the marks range in between. So 0%, 25%, 50%, 75%, 100%. So this data can be distributed among these ranges. Then the values related to these ranges so will be calculated the average. That average value is displayed here. So here in the given data marks, 29 is the least value. Then 100 is the highest value. So 29, you have only one value. So then 100 also, you have only one value. Then in between the ranges, 25, 50, 75%. So it gives the data. Now we will also execute this one. First create the matrix, a vector with the marks with equal to the given data. Then you can apply the quantile function simply. Default distribution, 25, 50, 75, 100. If you want your own distribution, you can use probability equal to sequence of. With that also, you will get this one. First you will execute this one, then we will go for next one. So first create a vector with marks equal to C of, now enter the marks 68, 82, then 63, 86, then 34, 96, then 100, 41, then 29, 51, then 75, 77, then 56, 59, the last one is 40. This is the vector. I can call marks. It display all the marks details. Then you can apply quantile. Q-A-N-T-I-L-E. Quantile of marks. See, which gives the default distribution. 0%, 25%, 50%, 75%, 100%, by dividing the values according to the ranges. So then by providing with our own range also, distribution. Here we will use probability equal to C of. So here you can provide 0, 25, 50, 75, 100. Same thing you can give like this also, C of. So same thing you can provide marks, then probability equal to C of, here what you have given 0, then 0.25, then 0.5, then 0.75, then 1. So here also you will get the same value, no change of the result. By default also it distributes like this only, 0, 25, 50, 75, 100, in between 0 to 1. Then if you want other ranges, other than the default values. Suppose here I have taken different values, you can see 0, then 20%, 40%, 60, 80, then 100. So defining our own probabilities. Here you will get according to that, the data is distributed. So now here, what are our own values we have taken? So 0, then 0.2, then 0.4, then 0.6, then 0.8, then 1. Now you can see. We have taken 0, 20%, 40%, 60%, 80%, 100%. This is our own probabilities. So without giving our own, default takes 0, 25, 50, 75, 100. So based on our need, requirement, we can provide the distribution. So here, these are all the commands what we executed and their corresponding outputs. Okay, that's all about, now we'll stop here. We discussed very basic fundamental ideas about the frequencies and the partitioning values. So you please try to revise these concepts and try to experiment it with some other data set. Take your own data set. Try to create your own data set, a smaller data set where you try to do this computation yourself and try to match it with the outcome of the software so that you can gain some confidence. And in the next lecture, we will try to deal with some more topics and see you in the next lecture. Till then, goodbye. Happy learning.